now we're getting into stuff. For every library that's represented in this room, there are different sets of expectations for that library. What is expected with the National Symphony is, I can guarantee you, very different than what's expected over at the Marine Band. I would say. Can you say what?
Sure.
And how we go about it is going to be very different. We all have some similar things that we do, but the expectations by the people up the food chain and how they tell those to us are going to be very different. So make sure that you have a complete job description for anybody that works in your library, including yourself. Included in that job description should be the hours. I'm not saying just 9 to 5. I'm saying things like, are expected to do concert duty, or have to work some weekends, will go on tour, stuff of that nature, okay? Our library does not have office hours posted because there was a famous bank commercial on the radio a number of years ago that would say, daytime, nighttime, Saturday too, we open our doors. That's our library. So we don't have hours per se. What is the reporting structure? Who reports to whom? In some orchestras, the librarian reports to the operations folks. In some orchestras, they report to the artistic folks. In our orchestra, I report directly to the executive director. That's pretty unusual, I think. But make sure that that's clearly defined. And if you have a human resource department or a human resources director, make sure you know who that person is and that they know what this job description says. This could be a saving grace down the road for a number of reasons. Outline your duties. We are back to the basics here, I realize that. But outline your duties. Are you responsible for writing the program notes? I hope not, but if you are, bless you. Are you responsible for keeping the timings of the pieces during the concert? I don't know. Some librarians do, some don't. Are you responsible for providing the instrumentations to everybody else? Detail all this stuff out. If you have a budget, who sets that budget for you? Does somebody say to you, I'm giving you $50,000 this year, how are you going to break it up? Or do you program to the budget to the program? We've had it both ways at the NSO. We have had program to the budget, and we have had budget to the program. And that they're very different approaches, so make sure that's spelled out, what control you have over your budget, okay? We have an odd thing. We have our symphony budget this year, not counting our salaries or the ASCAP BMI fees, comes to about, I'd say $165,000. Okay, now that's our rentals and our purchases and all this stuff. And office supplies. But oddly enough, if it's an office supply that the other offices use, that comes out of their budget, even if it comes to our library. Did that make any sense? Okay? So when I buy my scotch tape, it comes out of their budget. When I buy these, it comes out of my budget. It's really kind of convoluted, but it works. But just make sure you know who's got what. Okay. Now you have your job description. You've been hired. Congratulations. Okay. One other thing about job description. Make sure it mentions vacation, overtime, short-term disability, all that good stuff. Okay, your HR director probably has that covered, but you should know what those things are. And the unemployment number for the DC unemployment office up there on H Street, Penning Road, is 202-365-1242. Now, the reason I know that is, back when I was a freelance musician, when it was dark in August, you had to collect unemployment, you had to report to the local unemployment office. And I lived in Virginia, so they assigned me to a DC unemployment place, and this is true. I would have to go there and open up the Washington Post classified under the letter V and look for violinist to get my unemployment. There you go. But have that number on your refrigerator, never know when it'll come in. Okay. Library location and supplies. You know, as I mentioned, all of us have our own library spaces. But within those spaces, you should really insist on some things. You need to have adequate desk and storage space. You need to have a filing system of some kind, whether it's movable files, file cabinets, built-in shelving, whatever it is, you deserve to have it. Okay, so stick to your guns here. Office supplies, all these little goodies, okay? Access to a copier. Now, it would be really easy for me to stand up here and say everybody deserves their own photocopier. That is a very expensive proposition for a number of organizations. And whether you lease one or purchase one is probably out of the library's direct control. But you're going to have to lobby your managers to make sure that you have access to a photocopier 24/7. Because the library works hours when the rest of the staff doesn't. And you have to have access to that photocopier. Okay? I'm jealous of the libraries that have the really big photocopiers, like the blueprint size. Laura's smiling
well,
back there.
Well, I'm so jealous, it's dying a slow death.
I would love to have that. We actually have one digital photocopier at the moment that is okay. And we have our old photocopier that we love. But they're no longer making parts for it. So they have to kind of go to the copier graveyard and find parts for us when we need it now. But we're very blessed that we have two right there in the library. And if they both go down at the same time, which has only happened once, we can go upstairs since I just happen to know the code on that machine. reference books and catalogs. Many of you probably have access to the internet. This helps our jobs tremendously. If you are fortunate enough to have a computer right there in your library, this can help you in your research. And most of the publishers now have all of their holdings online, and it is a wonderful help. A wonderful help. And more often than not now, they also have all the pertinent information. They have the length of the piece, they have the instrumentation of the piece, they have everything you need right there. It's great stuff. If you don't have access to the internet at work, and you don't want to be doing this at 2:00 in the morning at home, please collect all of the in-print catalogs that are outside our main meeting room. Take those home, they're very handy. I was cleaning out some catalogs not too long ago, and I came across a little pamphlet that had slid into a bigger catalog, and I pulled it out, and lo and behold, it was in Vernon's handwriting. Vernon was my predecessor. Vernon has been gone from the National Symphony since 1986. This catalog was from 1971, and it had been hand-typed and stapled up in the corner, and I thought, this is really cool. Look at how far we have come, and the way we can research things now, it's just amazing, this little hand-typed thing. It was really, it was very touching.